this time, I would like to call the units to order.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the 2016 Veterans Day service. My name is Mike Hurt, and I'll be your master of ceremony for today's events. Special mention should be made that wherever we are in the program, at 11 a.m., we will face east towards City Hall, and the bell will toll 11 times. Patrick Henry once said, "The battle, sir, is not to the strong alone. It is to the vigilant, the active, and the brave." Today, we gather to recognize those who were strong, who were vigilant, and who were brave, our veterans. Veterans Day originated as Armistice Day on November 11th, 1919, and that was the first anniversary of the end of World War I. In 1954, it officially became Veterans Day as changed by President Eisenhower, so that we recognized all veterans. And today in 2016, you and I gather together to recognize America's heroes, its veterans, past and present, who proudly served in the United States Army, the United States Navy, the United States Marine Corps, the United States Air Force, and the United States Coast Guard. At this time, I request that Lee Schuff, DAV Chaplain, 17 Chaplain, give the invocation. Please uncover and bow your head.
Chaplain Lee.
On this Veterans Day, we honor all those women and men of our armed services who have served to protect and defend our Constitution and our country. We honor their service, their dignity, and their commitment. We pay honor to their valor and courage, and we give thanks for their lives. On this Veterans Day, bless the memory of those who died in the service of our nation. On this Veterans Day, bless those who are now serving in our armed forces. Keep them from harm's way wherever they serve, in Iraq or Afghanistan, Europe or Asia, here in our own nation. Bless them on land, in the air, and on the sea, and bring them home in safety to their family and friends. Bless this country that we may be a stronghold of peace and as advocate among the Council of Nations. Bless this gathering of patriots today that we may respectfully honor those who have carried the flag of our nation to the far corners of the earth to sustain the freedom that we have inherited from our ancestors and that we will pass on to our descendants. Amen.
Thank you so much, Chaplain Lee. And at this time, we will be led in the Pledge of Allegiance by the students of St. Francis Caprini. Miss Morris, if you'd be able to bring the kids around a little bit here. You can slide them through. And salute. Thank you so much. Let's give them a round of applause. That's fantastic. That's our future there, everybody. And at this time, we are going to have some welcoming remarks by Mr. Mark Harris.
Spangled Banner?
Yes.
Oh, hey, we're going to sing the Star Spangled Banner. So with that, Ellen Schmidt, if you could get us kicked off and I'll get the music.
We have to have these little glitches to make it interesting.
Ready?
Star Spangled Banner, yet we're
and might be the end of the last one.
Red stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, it flew through the night.
And at this time, we'll have Mr. Mark Harris, Winnebago County Executive, provide a few welcoming remarks. Mr. Harris.
Thank you. I want to welcome everybody to this Veterans Day services at the Winnebago County Courthouse. And this day, of course, is to honor military veterans who have served in the U.S. Armed Forces. The time of it is, of course, set at the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, to coincide with the armistice in World War I. But you know, many veterans do not receive the benefits to which they and their families are entitled. And I want it to be a goal in this county that every Winnebago County veteran have an appointment with a veteran service officer before the 100th anniversary of the armistice on this date in 2018, because that's the best way for veterans to get connected to the benefits that they are entitled to. And I can think of no better way to honor them than to connect them with those benefits. And to accomplish this, I'm calling on the neighbors and friends and families of veterans that may not have checked into what they're entitled to, and also to the veteran service organizations that do such a good job of helping to connect the veterans they know with those services. So again, I would hope that every veteran out there would try and make an appointment over the next 2 years with a veteran service officer here in the county. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Harris. Our guest speaker today is Command Sergeant Major Peter Running. I've had the privilege to know him since about, I think, 2009, and we are just blessed with an incredible individual that'll be speaking with us today. He began his military service in January 1983, and he joined the United States Army, and he had served nearly 5 years as an active duty MP, and that was over in Germany, Waldflicken, as well as Kansas. He then came back, served about 5 months in the Wisconsin Army National Guard with the 32nd MP Company, and then he enlisted in the United States Army Reserve in 1988. He joined the three of the 274th Infantry Battalion in Appleton as a drill sergeant. And he was immediately sent to the 84th Division Drill Sergeant School. And he graduated as the Distinguished Honor Graduate. He trained over 1,500 soldiers in basic combat training. In 1992, he transferred to the 84th and the Drill Sergeant School in Milwaukee, and he was a certified senior drill sergeant leader, and he trained over 500 drill sergeant candidates. In 1996, he transferred to the 85th in Arlington Heights, Illinois, and he was a division senior physical security NCO. Just to jump a little bit, in 2006, he was selected as a command sergeant major and assigned to the 407th Civil Affairs Battalion in Arden Hills, Minnesota. In 2009, where we first met, he was the command sergeant major for the 432nd Civil Affairs Battalion in Green Bay. In 2010, he deployed to Iraq and he was assigned to the 17th Psychological Operations Task Force. And he was the command sergeant major responsible for all of the reserve components, IAP forces, and theater. He then returned to the 432nd, and in 2011, he was selected as the command sergeant major of the 308th. He then even moved up further, and then in 2013, he was selected as the command sergeant major of the 353 Civil Affairs Command in Staten Island, Illinois. The schools that he has attended in the military, it's just incredible. He has gone to the MP school, the infantry school, the artillery school, the drill sergeant school, the basic airborne course, the combat lifesaver course. He's the unit armor management course, and from PLDC, BNOC, ANOC, the non-residential Sergeant Major's Academy, class 29, just to name a few. His civilian education, an associate's degree in criminal justice at Fox Valley Tech, a bachelor's in science degree in criminal justice administration from Mount Scenario. And he is also a graduate of the FBI National Academy. And he's currently pursuing a graduate degree from the American Military University. He is a busy guy. His decorations include the Bronze Star Medal, the Meritorious Service Medal, three of them, Army Commendation Medal, six. Five of those, the Army Achievement Medal, six, the Good Conduct Medal, the Army Reserve Component Achievement Medal, six of those, National Defense Service Medal, two of those, the Global War on Terrorism Service Medal and Iraq Campaign Medal, two of those, and Army Service Ribbon, Overseas Service Ribbon, and he also has the German Army Marksmanship Award. He has the Drill Sergeant Badge and the Parachutist Badge. In his civilian capacity, he serves as the chief of police in the village of Winneconne, so be careful when you're going through. And CMS, he also, a command sergeant major running, he does reside in Winneconne. His wife Jody is here present with us today. And I can tell you, a supportive spouse is just everything. And they serve together. He has two children, a son Andrew, who is also an Iraqi Freedom veteran, his daughter Brittany, daughter-in-law Cassandra. He's also a proud grandfather. He has granddaughter Brianna and a grandson Dallas. So everybody here today, please give a warm welcome to Command Sergeant Major Peter Running of the United States Army Civil Affairs Psychological Operations Command.
We're at the 11 o'clock hour.
We're at 11?
We're at 11. Take that pause. So I'm going to turn right back over to you for a moment.
At this time, we are at 11 o'clock, and as indicated in the beginning of the service, we are going to toll the bell 11 times. And ringing the bell is Fred Hamill, and Fred is the president of the Oshkosh Patriotic Council. Fred. Thank you, Fred.
Good morning. Thank you, Lieutenant Colonel retired Mike Hurt. Appreciate the kind introduction. A lot of words, a lot of training, just proves that people can be trained. Mr. Harris, honored guests, veterans. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's Veterans Day celebration. As you heard, the first Veterans Day or Armistice Day was held some 98 years ago when a temporary cessation of hostilities went into effect on the 11th hour of that 11th day of the 11th month. The significance of November 11 rings true to its origin. It was the end of the war to end all wars. It's a date when those who serve or served are honored and recognized for their contributions to freedom and the American way. In my humble opinion, every day is Veterans Day, and every opportunity a person gets to thank a veteran for their service should do so. It is but a small token of appreciation a grateful nation has for its veterans and should be practiced daily. Now, I will tell you that every veteran I know, speak to, or have thanked for their service, myself included, will tell you that they appreciate the recognition, but they're very humble sort and will tell you it isn't necessary. I'd like to take a moment to recognize the veterans who are here today representing 75 years of war and conflict. Our World War II, Korean, Vietnam, Persian Gulf, Iraq, and Afghanistan war veterans. Let us not forget to recognize those who served before, during, and between each of those wars, for their service was a key component in maintaining a ready force to keep America free, with liberties and rights not found elsewhere in the world. I'd like to point out that not only are there veterans in the formation before you, but there are veterans standing in the audience amongst you. To you, veterans, brothers in arms, friends, I say thank you and happy Veterans Day. I'm humbled to be in your midst. Let's give them a round of applause. Let us also not forget those who have given all they could give to maintain those liberties for future generations. Mr. Hurt mentioned something, and I refer to it as the pseudo-veteran. It's a group that deserves recognition but often doesn't get it. Those who have sacrificed by giving their loved ones to the armed forces only to wait for their safe return. Our families and loved ones, they too deserve recognition for their sacrifice. We who have volunteered or been called to duty for the myriad reasons we have all heard before, duty, honor, country, by draft, not by choice, by necessity in turbulent times. We, just men and women, fathers, mothers, sons and daughters, were called to do a job that is different in that it calls for regular people to do extraordinary things in a place or time that puts them at great risk of physical harm or death. Some by choice, some by directive, all for the same reason, to ensure the liberty and freedom our nation enjoys remains present for current and future generations. The job they did, and when asking a veteran, was just a job to them, and they really didn't do anything, or they just played a small role in whatever unit they happened to be assigned. Their job was actually a significant part of the operation of a much greater organization. The veteran knows that when they serve, they become a part of something much greater than themselves. I recall just 6 short years ago at an operating base in Iraq on November 11th, 2010. Some young soldiers were talking to the old man, that would have been me, drinking energy drinks in the middle of the night, celebrating Veterans Day. They had all served less than 5 years, were on their first enlistment, and were standing in harm's way. The end of the war had been announced and was just a month away. Yet they faced the constant threat of rockets and mortars. They took it all in stride, making comments about why they joined the Army and what they planned to do when they returned home. Family, college, civilian occupations, friends, even their pets. And then they talked about their future. And these things were all said as if their current status, that of standing on foreign soil in a faraway place with an unseen and often unpredictable threat, was just a waypoint in their life journey. It was a moment that I refer to often when I visit Army Reserve units across the country. It reminds me of just how great a nation we have and renews my faith in the future of our country and military. I often tell soldiers how humbled I am by their professionalism, intelligence, dedication, sense of duty, and honor. Those soldiers who I served with overseas, in Germany and in units all over the country, still remain in contact today. Social media has been an excellent means to bridge the space between our communities and homes. We continue the discussions on what
they want to do when they grow up. We talk about family, jobs, our place in life, as if we had just picked up the conversation we left on the sandy soil of Iraq or on that military base where we were stationed together. That camaraderie is unmatched anywhere. It is a bond, one where we truly care for each other, for we have been a part of an organization that breeds a brotherhood and esprit de corps. There are veterans whose wounds are visible and those whose wounds are not visible. They show unimaginable resiliency, but not all do or can. They deserve the assistance they need, but may not be willing to ask. We should all do what we can to recognize a veteran in crisis and provide them assistance and support. The support of friends, family, and the community are key to ensure they remain resilient, healthy, and strong. The future holds many unknowns, and with it, conflict. Conflict that will certainly ask for Americans to step up, to call upon their profound patriotic spirit, to ask them to place themselves in danger to uphold democracy by answering the call to serve. I have no doubt that there will always be a part of our society who steps up voluntarily to give of themselves for the greater good. And for that, I am grateful. In closing, I'd like to thank you for the privilege to be here today and be a part of today's Veterans Day celebration. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Command Sergeant Major Running. Truly inspiring. At this time, we will have the placing of the wreaths. Carrying the wreaths are Herman Ratz, World War II veteran, and Norbert Gray, Korean veteran. Gentlemen. At this time, Alan Schmidt will lead us in the singing of God Bless America. The lyrics are in the back page of your program.
Just want me to do it.
Please. Let's see if we can do this one right. Now I want everybody to sing out nice and loud. You all know this. And the words are in the back of your program, as you might say. God bless Chaplain Lee Schuff, could you please provide the closing prayer? Please uncover and bow your head.
God of peace, we pray for those who have served our nation and have laid down their lives to protect and defend our freedom. We pray for those who have fought, whose spirits and bodies are scarred by war, whose nights are haunted by memories too painful for the light of day. We pray for those who serve us now, especially for those in harm's way. Shield them from danger and bring them home. Turn the hearts and minds of our leaders and our enemies to the work of justice and the harvest of peace. May the peace you left us, the peace you gave us, be the peace that sustains us, the peace that saves us. Hear our prayer. Amen.
Thank you so much, Chaplain Lee. The United Veterans Honor Guard at this time will conduct an honor salute. This concludes today's ceremony. Thank you, everybody, for coming. God bless America. At this time, units will break ranks and are dismissed.
Left, face, forward, arm.